Hey everybody, welcome to Bigfoot RC Live, show number 25, and that's right, we're giving away a new Durango, right here, DEST 210, ready for winning. Some lucky viewer tonight's going home with this thing. Well, I guess not really going home with it, but you'll get it eventually in the mail or something. So, welcome everybody, thanks for joining us tonight. It's our 25th episode. Sorry for missing out on you guys last week. Jeff, shut off your TV. totally blame me, even though it wasn't my fault, but that's no problem. So what's going on, guys? Hopefully you had a good week, didn't miss us too much, and you're ready to go for some cool new RC news and the usual stuff that we do. Introductions real quick. We'll head over to Adam. Say hi, Adam.
Hi, guys. Adam the intern.
Jeff, who still hasn't shut off his TV.
It's off.
Is it? So I can hear somebody. I'm still blaming you.
I'm telling
it's
you,
always Adam. Your TV. Adam's watching YouTube videos or something.
I would spin my camera around and show you, but my room's a mess right now. So
it's actually Kevin, and he's just like, those two suck. This is awesome. And over to Kevin.
Hey, guys. Kevin the sales guy. We sold nothing.
He's officially Kevin Ragu.
Yep.
Awesome. So, let's see. Hey, so for folks in the chat window, feel free to type in questions. Jeff and or Kevin will most likely read through them and check things out and pick questions for us to answer live on the show. So feel free to chat it up in there while we're broadcasting and talking about the news. Sadly, Tim couldn't be with us this evening. He's some sort of graduation or something. So congrats. Let's see, who else are we missing? I don't know if Covey's going to be here or not. We'll see. And Craig was going to be here. He was sort of here at the last minute and then had a bail. So, hey, Craig, if you're watching or listening to this on your iPhone or something, good luck with everything going on. All right, let's jump into RC News. What's hot in the news section? We saw some people mentioning the paint news that's come around. We could hop over to Kevin, see if he's got any official news. But we saw some people mentioning it in the chat.
Yeah, I know a couple of people have already kind of posted some of the details of the letter, but testers announced officially within the last couple of days that they are completely discontinuing their Floqual and Pactra line, which includes...
Oh.
Floqual meaning primarily for train stuff, and of course Pactra being for the RC car bodies, but it's a shame. We will.
I'm gonna have to agree. They've been around forever. Like, you know, they both make some pretty good rattle can stuff, and you know, us basher types don't have time for airbrushing most of the time. I mean, if you've looked at any of Cubby's latest reviews, he's got like a pure white body or a pure this or that, and he's just out there and shakes it up, sprays it, and goes. So yeah, it'll hurt to see those guys disappear off the planet. Definitely a bummer. That being said, we've been doing a lot of stuff with Spastics lately. We really dig some of their stuff. Their stuff's pretty cool because it makes my horrible painting look a lot better. So, like, all I've got to do is, like, grab a new Proline body, I mask some windows, and, like, maybe I run a couple stripes or, like, one paint thing. I spray Spastics all over the thing. Then it looks awesome. Like, you don't have to do anything. It's just so shiny. You know, you go with some crazy candy colors or something. Everybody's like, whoa, nice body. I'm like, yeah, I painted it in like 6 minutes. So definitely dig their stuff.
Tonight's
pretty cool.
Brought to you by Spastics.
Yeah, tonight by Spastics, the home of shiny paint. I should have had a can down here. It would have been awesome. Pop it up. Ding. Yeah. So yeah, you know, you guys can make that jump over, but I'm definitely sorry to see the other guys go. It's some good stuff. So maybe somebody will pick up the line or something. We'll see. See what happens over there. I'm gonna hop over.
It's fast color too.
Right, fast color is good stuff. No. Fast color is rumored to be disappearing, Jeff.
What? Well, yep. I guess I have to get Creatix then.
Yeah, it's getting crazy. If fast color is really going, you know, and that's still, I think, on the rumor mill. I don't know if that's been officially announced, but yeah, it'll definitely suck to see those guys go. Watch, you're not going to be able to buy, like, either of these. There's going to be, like, a flood on the market. And they're like, Cubby's just going to go in and buy, like, every can they've got at every hobby shop near him. So they'll have to invoke, like, one of those, you know, hey, are you over 18? They're going to think he's, like, tagging some wall somewhere. So, other big recent news, Traxxas, our buddies over at Traxxas, have started shipping stuff without batteries. Which is a good and bad thing. You know, it's one of those, hey, the prices are cheaper. Not a lot cheaper, but cheaper. You know, cheaper is always good. We like to save some money. But, you know, on the other hand, for the total newbies who don't have batteries and don't have everything and don't know what's going on, it's great for them to get it all in the box. You know, any thoughts from you guys? What do you think? What's your opinion on missing batteries, Jeff?
Camera's falling off my belly. I would have liked to see the prices drop a little bit more, but it's Traxxas. You're going to pay for it.
Right. Yeah, and you know they definitely haven't been that cheap lately. Excuse the reach. I'm trying to grab soda. What are your thoughts, Kevin?
You know, being in the hobby shops, I've been starting to see that Traxxas is kind of sneaking some non-battery, ready-to-run boxes out there. I think that defeats the purpose of ready-to-run, considering that's what it says on the box, but, you know, it's for the LiPo ones, I can understand Traxxas batteries, at least in the LiPo department, are a little bit expensive for what they are, so I like them giving me availability of get your own. Right. But this whole disappearing batteries out of the box thing definitely is going to turn away some fresh customers, maybe not the bash crowd.
Right. Yeah, because I'm sure like the hobby shops will always have some sort of cheap alternative. You know, that's like, well, you're going to need a battery, and here's 12 to choose from, you know. Yeah. So.
Yeah.
Historically, ready to run didn't include a battery anyway up until the last year or two. And
right.
When Traxxas was doing ready-to-runs back in the early 90s, they didn't include a battery or a charger. I think they were one of the first companies to actually do fully ready-to-run cars while everybody else was doing kits.
But, yeah, they were definitely up on the list. The other thing, just looking over at the comments real quick in the chat, some people are saying that, you know, if they're going to dump the battery, why not save a couple more bucks and dump the chargers? Yeah. You know, why is there still a charger in my box? And I totally agree with that. If you're not giving me the battery, don't give me a charger with nothing to charge. You know,
as a trickle charger too.
Right. Save me the extra $5 or whatever you're charging me, and dump that thing. You know. So, yeah, you know, hey, prices are down, so that's always good. But, you know. Let's be a little bit smarter about it. We'll see if there's like a backlash or not. And I doubt it. I'm pretty sure everybody will be buying just as many Traxxas as they always have been. So, other news. If you didn't catch it, Tim and Cubby and a couple other people threw up the ProTech RC LiPo battery review. If you guys are into the whole LiPo scene, nobody's really doing anything nearly as detailed as our LiPo reviews. So if you're itching for a new LiPo or just looking to get some information on the ProTech line, definitely check out that review. We just posted it up there. It's pretty good. We already had a bunch of emails coming in talking about how great the review is, and they love all the charts and the comparisons and everything. everything. So if you're thinking about going LiPo, or if you're looking for to switch a brand or something like that, check the review out for sure. Other things in the news. Proline's releasing all sorts of cool little scale stuff. Fuel cell, nitrous bottle, mini keg, you know, a little propane tank, that sort of thing. So if you're into the insane scale crawler scene, Proline's really got you covered for the tiny stuff, I think.
Go back to that last picture.
This one?
Yeah. Is that a beer keg or am I, or is the picture just really blurry?
No, it's a beer keg.
That's keg.
Woo! Promoting drinking and driving.
So, you know, I'm waiting to see the first scale truck with like 9 of those on the back. You know?
True to life.
And like, you know, one sitting in the passenger seat. You know, like totally. That's the way to do it. That'd be awesome. Yes, that stuff's cool. We were just reading through a bunch of the rules for like the upcoming Axial events, with like the Hand of God event stuff and their rules and everything else. And we noticed like one of their things is there has to be a minimum of six scale items on your vehicle. So if you're looking to make that rule class, Proline's got you covered, you know, pretty quickly. So some good stuff. That recon event's coming around soon as well. I know it's hitting St. Louis, which is actually kind of near us here in the Midwest. So there's a good chance a couple of us will get down there for that. So if you're into the hardcore scale scene, and you're going to be near the St. Louis area or within a few hours of it, definitely check out that recon event. That's going to be awesome. So we'll have some more details when it gets closer. Yeah, I think we've got a good few weeks away yet. So definitely coming up soon.
From the chat.
Oh, from the chat. Jeff's nose from the chat that, live. Here we go.
That, is there anything new on that rumor we started about the Traxxas fifth scale?
Not yet. It's funny because every once in a while when a rumor comes up like that, and we didn't start it, by the way, I don't think. We just sort of heard some stuff about it. But every once in a while when we're way off, like way off in the rumor mill, they'll contact us, you know, but who knows. But we didn't get any official forms of denial from Traxxas. We'll put it that way. So,
well, they're rumoring big things at RCX because they're like, oh, we're going to have our cars, our test track, and more. I'm like, well, okay.
See how we'll see. We'll see what happens. So
they'll have Peter Vieira's awesome voice.
Yeah. Peter Vieira That's rocks. He's always got the, hey!
The
fastest name in radio control. He turns on like that radio voice. It's like a switch, too. Like, hey, Peter, hey, Brian, what's going on? And then someone else would, like, hand him a microphone. He's like, hey, how's it going? Peter Vieira, Traxxas, what's going on? So, and then he flips it right back off. What's up, guys? We love Peter. Peter's awesome. So, always good stuff.
He's a rock, though. Don't try to get anything out of him.
He is tough. He is extremely tough to crack on the rumor side. So, we even knew about the funny car stuff. Like, we had a bunch of details for the funny car stuff, and he still wouldn't tell me. I'm like, dude, we know it's coming. I know this is what it is. He's like, I don't know what you're talking about. like, seriously. Come on, man. So
one tough nut.
He is. That guy's rough. Speaking of axial and scale stuff, we've got, let's see if I've got a picture of it here, the axial hardtop to sort of complete your Jeeps for the 2012 Jeep Wrangler Unlimited Rubicon body, whatever you want to call it. They've got this pretty cool looking thicker, I think it's like a 0.40 polycarbonate plastic now to add a roof to your Jeep. So always cool. See, now you can fit a bunch of kegs in the back and they won't even fall out, right? They can just kind of roll around in the back now. So that's pretty cool. Let's see, what else is going on? What other pictures do I have loaded from recently? We've got this one. We got the new FX Motors. Let's see if I can find the news on this thing. So they're called the FX Royal Nitro Racing Nitro Engine thing, something. No one's really thrown a new motor brand into the mix in a long time. So there's a few of us that are pretty excited about this. You know, coming from the X-Ray and Mr. Huddy over there, it'll be interesting to see if they solve any nitro issues. Like, is it just going to be another nitro motor? You know they're not going to be cheap. Those guys are going to be, you know, top of the line stuff. So it'll be interesting to see, you know, is it easier to tune? Do they flame out as much?
Yeah, fuel injection.
Right. Fuel injection would be awesome. Heck, we've been wishing for fuel injection for years now. It'd be awesome if somebody could figure that out. And it's not impossible. It works in the real world. You know, they just got to throw enough money at it to make it happen. So, I'm all for fuel injection. Make that happen. You are really quiet, Jeff. I don't know what that was.
That was me mumbling.
Oh, mumbling all right.
Myself. Sorry.
Okay, no, that's
maybe
fine.
It's not
anything on Arma? Anything new from Arma that I thought we just announced or posted stuff like 2 weeks ago about Arma and stuff or whatever?
Arma stuff is still on the horizon. It was actually kind of funny. I actually got a mini wrist slap recently. I mentioned some sort of new Arma product. I won't even mention what product I mentioned coming down the pipe. And I got a, hey, how do you know about that? And who did you talk to? And, you know, so I will say this. There's definitely new Arma stuff coming. But I'm not going to say what or who or when or why because those phone calls are never that much fun. As much as they sound like fun and as much as, like, Jeff and Tim and Cubby all love hearing about my phone call experience, it's not as fun on my end as it seems to be for those guys. And they're like, they said what? You know. So. But yeah, there's definitely new Arma stuff for the Arma fans. Hold your breath, because it's going to be soon. It's going to be real soon.
Anything new from HPI? They've been
real quiet. HPI has been
scary quiet.
Yeah, Kevin called that one. Those guys have been really, really quiet, and I think a lot of it has to do with the new exclusive distribution deals with Great Plains, Habaco, sort of thing. So I think all the people that normally are putting out the PR and stuff like that, all that sort of changing command maybe, we'll see how that goes. So I think they're trying to get all their ducks in a row, and nobody wants to step on anybody else's feet right now.
Even my connections in HPI are like, I don't know what you're talking about, even though HPI posts pictures of things like their 18 scale touring cars and stuff. It's like, oh, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm like, it's on your Facebook page. And they just kind of stay quiet.
Yeah, nobody wants to say anything over there till the chain of command has been figured out. So, you know, we're still dying for the Octane stuff, you know, start shipping it, take my money, whatever has to happen, you know, make it happen. So hopefully soon, hopefully real soon. If Wrench is watching tonight, we got your cars all over the place, man. We got the Kyosho comic type cars. Check these things out. They announced these a little just recently. I believe they're 18 scale, so they're a little small, but you know they're kind of interesting looking. There's some people. This is one of those products that you love or hate. And Jeff, love or hate, comic car.
As a minis guy, I love it. If it were a 10 scale or something bigger, I don't know that I'd like it too much.
Right, so you're happy with it as long as it's small.
Yeah. It fits small. It makes sense to have a small, cute little comic-y thing going in around a tiny little track, but if it's, you know, if it was a big 1/10 scale or 1/8 scale rally car, it'd look pretty goofy going around a track with a bunch of more scale-looking stuff.
All right. Kevin, love it or hate it?
Being a Mini-Z racer myself, I kind of like it because the one thing that the demonstration video showed that I loved the most was, oh, hey, it'll actually handle jumps and stuff like that. So being on a Mini-Z platform and still being able to run like a real RC car, it should be a lot of fun and good for those new basher types.
That's cool. I'm on the fence. You know, I had a real long conversation with Cubby a while back, and it was one of those, like, you know, we went back on the love-hate thing or whatever, but it was one of those, like, it's new, and no one's done it yet, which is cool. You know, we're sick of seeing the same stuff over and over and over. It's finally nice to see somebody try something a little different and see if it catches on or not. You know, whether or not it's great or whatever, but it's nice to see somebody bring something new to the table. And the reason I mentioned Wrench earlier, he plays a couple of games. I think one of them's on Facebook, Car Town or something like that. And all their cars kind of look cartoony, you know, so we were giving him a hard time. I was saying it'd be neat if they came out with cars that look like that, but they were definitely more like his Car Town stuff. So, like, that was a cartoony Camaro. Or, you know, the cartoony Mustang, or, you know, if they go after a big line of licensed cars, you know, that'd be kind of neat. So we'll see. See what happens. I mentioned this a little bit earlier in the week. Somebody did the crazy custom Lego vehicle, and there's a whole video, and it's super detailed and super complicated, but it was pretty cool. You know, I just thought it was worth posting. If you didn't watch the video, the fact that the guy actually made controller out of multiple parts and hooked it together and gave himself ways for, like, shifting into 5 different gears and stuff was pretty cool. So.
Yeah, those Lego nerds are something else.
Cat-ham sort of look, but it was pretty neat. I'm blaming Jeff for that thing.
Car.
What'd you say? I still can't hear you. You're quiet over there.
What?
What? You're like what? Sitting on your microphone or something.
I am.
You probably are.
I totally am. Just wait for it. I had a burrito for dinner tonight. No, I've just been waiting for it.
Thanks for that. Now you know why we do these in separate places, right? Let's see. We should probably, I've got some more news to go through, but we should probably tease the contest a little bit here. So, here's what we're doing. We're giving away a Durango. We're giving away this Durango, actually, right here. There, that one. Perfect, right? So, what you're going to have to do, and we really want the people that are on live to win one of these things. But because we get lots of controversy and people are like, oh, I answered it first or a question first or this or that, we're going to have...
Oh, no, Brian froze.
I froze? Did I?
I don't know.
You got quiet.
Oh, we're going to have, yeah, that'll be it. All right, send your email now to... we're going to have you guys email, so pull up your email software or whatever you're going to use to email, and you're going to have to email to pics@bigsquidrc.com. That's pics@bigsquidrc.com. Jeff is going to ask you guys a question shortly. And his eyes should get real big because I just put him on the spot. He totally didn't know he had asked a question. So Jeff's going to ask some sort of question. it's not going to be a difficult question, but all you have to do is answer it and email picksquidrc.com, and we will pick a winner of somebody who has the correct answer. But this way you guys aren't all freaking out over the chat and spamming everything, and everybody's going nuts over the winner of the drawing. So, but he's randomly going to pick a winner for someone who answered correctly and go from there. So, remember, picks at picksquidrc.com. Jeff's going to have about a minute to come up with a question.
Does it have to be RC related?
No. Which will make it even more interesting. I wouldn't suggest, like, okay, what 16-year-old won the American Music Award for, RC related would be a nice touch, considering that this is an RC show, but I'm not going to hold you to it. So, you're the question, man. Totally up to you. Speaking of scale stuff earlier, Tim Covey also went to the Show Me Scalers competition, which apparently was pretty awesome. They had a ton of people show up. They had a bunch of good events going on. It was good to see people actually not afraid to get muddy. You know, we've had that conversation before, whether or not it's a shelf queen or you actually use it and have fun. Tim took some awesome shots, so definitely check out the article. Well, we've got a big article with where everybody placed, a ton of pictures, and it's really cool stuff. I don't know if it's the same place that the recon event in St. Louis is going to be coming up, but if it was near St. Louis, I don't know if it was actually in St. Louis. But definitely check that thing out if you're into the whole scale-y stuff. What else do we got going on? I can do this. Check it out. If you want to see Jeff's whole head, we have Jeff and Jeff Inception. That picture is awesome, by the way. So I took that about a minute before we went live, and I already miss Adam. Poor Adam.
Poor Adam.
I know, right?
What happened to him?
He's been texting me. Like, he lost his internet again. And he's, like, all upset because it is always him. Like, his internet runs for, like, 15 minutes because he's on for the whole time where we're prepping for the show. Like, we all kind of hop on around 8:30, 8:40, and we make sure everybody's stuff's working. And Adam's good till about 5 minutes into the show. And then it just dies. I've got a feeling, like, his parents are watching in one room, and then his brother and sister probably pull it up in another room, and then he uses all of his bandwidth, and, like, his provider just kicks him off or something. So,
sorry. All right, I got a question.
All right, Jeff's got a question. Now, remember, you have to mail the answer to picks@bigsquidrc. And the correct answer. And we're not going with the first person or whatever. You'll have, like, you know, till the end of the show, you got like 5 minutes to give us the answer, and we're going to pick a winner. All right, Jeff.
And the person who already emailed to enter the contest, I haven't asked the question yet.
Hey, whoever entered, do you know who entered? Did somebody enter recently?
Yeah, just like 2 minutes ago.
All right. How about this? Everybody who enters the contest, add this to your entry, add an address, and I will mail you guys stickers. So, you know, if you're watching and you're going to send your contest entry, even if you didn't win the car or the truck, you can get stickers in the mail. So attach your address. All right, Jeff, let's hear it. I like want to answer it myself.
All right, here we go. Going back a page. What is the name of the person who won our Proline Rat Rod prize pack contest?
Oh, that's a good one.
It was announced Sunday.
All right.
Try to go back a page and take a look at it. Email that answer, picks@bigsquidrc.com.
You have 30 seconds. Go. And don't forget to include your address.
Go.
So now we can do whatever we want because nobody is watching the show right now. We've just lost all of our viewers. Good job, Jeff. Because like, no one is actually going to like open another window. They're just going to like click on the next page now, and we've lost everybody. There's probably
already
like,
lost
three people
two.
Watching.
So when's Tim's volleyball season going to be over?
I think it's actually over. He's actually, his daughter like graduates tonight, so he's doing the whole graduation thing. And mine's tomorrow, so.
You're graduating tomorrow? Congratulations.
Yes, I am. I'm finally out of 8th grade. How awesome is that, right?
Woo!
It's been the longest 20 years of my life. I finally, after like 7 8th grade teachers, I finally found one that was like, just get out of my class. So that's good. Let's see. Hopefully we still got some people on there. Everybody answering the questions. That'd be sweet.
We're down 6.
Getting a few in. They're starting to trickle in.
All right. Glad to see you guys answering the question. Are any of them right?
yeah.
Cool. All right, guys. So if you're just tuning in, you probably have another minute or two to answer the following question from Jeff.
Let's give it a little longer.
You have to ask the question, Jeff.
What?
You have to ask the question.
What question?
The question. I said for people that were tuning in right now.
I already asked the question.
Yeah, but they might have just tuned in.
Who won our ProLine Rat Rod prize pack from last Sunday? Who was the winner? What's their name?
Hint, it wasn't me.
Picks@bigsquidrc.com.
Wasn't me either. Hey, and if anybody knows that guy, I don't think he's still sent me his shipping
address. Yeah, it's in here.
Oh, good.
He says apparently his Verizon email account is working now.
Oh.
But it's in the picks@bigsquidrc.
All right, cool. I emailed him like 3 different accounts and like an email and like maybe he doesn't want the prize. All right, some lucky winner is getting a new Durango. So that's awesome. So while Jeff's trying to figure all that stuff out and grab that stuff, see what else we have in the news. A couple of people released, we had some planes. There's a new Park Zone plane that I think we just recently talked about. It's the...
the Wolf.
Yeah, the Wolf 190A, which is basically a bind and fly coming up. Which means you supply the radio and I think just the radio. It should have a receiver and everything else in it, right? For the bind and fly? And
if it's a bind and fly, yes. If it's a bind and fly basic, it needs a battery as well.
Right. So, you know, it's a pretty cool looking plane. I think it's like $199. So for you plane guys, looks pretty awesome. And we also just talked about, let's see, plane news.
Pretty freaking awesome.
Yeah, this thing's the large scale, 86-inch wingspan. You know, holy cow.
Yeah.
So if you're into the giant scale stuff, that thing's looking pretty awesome. It's got retractable landing gear, the whole bit. And this one is from Top Flight, so a little Spitfire gas action. ProLine announced a...
what?
You know, us Basher guys like, because I am way too lazy to actually glue stuff, so I'm happy that they're putting out a bunch of different types of ProLine pre-glued tires ready to go. I can just order a setup and be done with it. So if you guys are like me and glue your fingers together a lot, and got us covered. Okay, Jeff, thank you. I said, how are the entries
going? I couldn't hear you. I think you froze for a second.
Dope. Sorry, guys.
It was just suddenly dead air, and it's not like you'd leave any opening.
No, I just keep talking until until somebody shuts me up. So.
Yep.
Do we have any cool questions? We're waiting on Jeff to for all the entries to come in, because we know it takes a couple of minutes. Kevin, we got any cool questions from the chat room?
We had one person asking if anyone from Big Squid flies, which I've been kind of handling in the chat, but I fly a little. I have a couple of helis, and I know 3D Bill flies. I know you crash, boss, but...
Yeah, I crash a lot of stuff. 3D Bill is kind of our Uber pilot guy. I fly quads and, you know, that sort of thing. I've flown planes, and I crash a lot of planes. So, but I'm not a huge plane guy. Any of the really difficult technical things I usually hand over to 3D Bill and say, here, go fly less sucky than I fly. So, and then he'll hand it back to me and go, okay, I'm done flying, your turn, and then I crash it, and we're done. So, usually how those go.
Well, now we're starting to get a second round of emails trickling in, so we got to give it a couple more minutes.
That's fine. No problem. We'll look at Jeff's pretty face. Questions from the chat from you guys? What's going on out there? And what's going on in the RC world? Actually, I got a question for you guys. For the people...
Oh, we lost him.
Ooh, me?
Yep.
Aw.
Your internet sucks tonight, Brian.
Does it? That's not cool.
Yep.
Oh, there's a question in the chat.
Am I back?
There you're back.
All right. Glad to be back. Before you get to your question, Kevin, I want to ask real quick, how many people are into the scale scene, like serious scale scene? Like you have to have that ProLine tag on your truck. We're just trying to gauge, like, you know, do people want some more scale coverage out there, or, you know, that sort of thing. So it got a ton of likes on Facebook, like Tim coverage of that last event, the Shoney Scaler guys, ton of likes and everything. So that was pretty cool. So we might be doing some more, but I figured I'd ask you guys live right now, who's into the chat scene, or who's into the chat scene? Who's into the scale scene? What's our question, Kevin? What's going on over there?
Sean was asking if any of us have flown that AR drone, and I know I have, and it's a fun little flyer, especially for indoors. I haven't flown it outside yet, but...
I know somebody who has flown an AR drone.
I know somebody who owns an AR drone.
Exactly. And that would be Jeff.
Go, Jeff, go!
Jeff, you're on. Sure. Go.
Duh.
Hey, check out my ventriloquist. I'm going to do the, I'm going to drink while I make Jeff talk.
It's not working, Brian.
You're ruining my...
I'm just gonna maintain silence while you look like a fool. No, I have the first gen AR drone, and it doesn't get flown a lot anymore. When I first got it, it got flown quite a bit, but...
Well, it's going to get it flown a lot soon.
Pretty cool flying it from the iPad and watching the video streaming back to it. The range sucked, but it was still a novel thing.
It's going to get flown a lot soon because I just recently got a Max Amps upgrade battery pack for you. So
yeah, I think you said you were going to mail that to me like 2 months ago.
I know, and it's still sitting here, I think. So
I think it was longer than 2 months ago.
You and your
we have all the problems.
You
with
and your I live in a different country than the rest of you guys. I feel like I'm ready to go. Yo, what's going on? All right. So tonight, Jeff, do we have our entries for the contest?
Yeah, I got a few names here.
All right. So you have to randomly pick a winner.
Randomly pick a winner, as long as I got it right.
That cannot be Kevin, or me, or Tim, or Adam, or 3D Bill, or Jeff's brother.
Just for the record, the winning answer was Shelby S. of somewhere in Pennsylvania. And since I answered it right, I'm the winner.
Boo.
Our winner tonight is Eric Gustafson. from Minnesota.
Woohoo! Oh, Eric! All right, Eric. Eric Gustafson. Congratulations, buddy. You just won a new Durango. All right. Hey, so his address is in there? Do we need any info from him? We're all good?
Let's see. Did I see? Well, I told you he was from Minnesota, just right there. Gustafson, Minnesota on the box.
Yeah, we'll see if he gets to him.
That'd be perfect. His email for his address is on there and everything. So.
Awesome. Cool. Congrats, Eric.
Pretty much everybody emailed their address for stickers.
Yep, we'll be sending stickers to everybody. Thank you very much. Also, thanks to everybody for hanging out tonight. I know we missed you. You guys missed us probably not as much as we missed you, but we definitely missed you last week. So thanks for tuning back in. And I think we're going to be calling it unless anybody's got anything they want to say real quick. Any goodbye messages or anything?
That burrito I ate was really good. If you're ever in Pueblo, go to El Nopal and get a monster burrito.
I hope they're a sponsor.
They are. Free monster burritos for life.
Right. All right, guys. Thanks again for hanging out in the chat with us. Congratulations to Eric. we'll be sending that new truck out to you guys soon. Thanks to everybody who entered. We'll be sending you guys stickers. If you're watching this replay and it's not Wednesday, whatever the heck the date is today, the 22nd of May 2013, and it's before 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, I'm not mailing you free stickers. So, like, all the people that are going to be sending me emails tomorrow.
Just because it would be totally awesome. If you're watching this on May 22nd, 2014, totally mail him and he'll send you stickers.
Jeff will personally deliver the stickers to your house. All right, guys. Thanks, Adam, who was almost sort of here with us for a little bit. Thanks to Jeff. Thanks, Kevin, as always. Thanks to all of our viewers. You guys rock. And we will see you next week. Later, guys. Bye-bye.